to Jesus, Satan, leave me alone. My husband is coming to take me away. New everlasting love. I'm married to Jesus, Satan, leave me alone. I'm married, Satan, leave me alone. My husband is coming to take me away. New everlasting love. Good morning.
Good morning to you too. So you are set to go to the market? Hmm?
Yes, brother, I'm set.
Fantastic. Swear.
Swear?
Yes, swear.
Swear that what?
No, swear that within yourself, you are satisfied and happy that you're going to the market like this.
Brother Cosmos, I don't need to swear. I'm ready to go to the market now. Yes.
Rosanna, now listen to me. Let me not ever see you walk out of this house looking like this. Do you understand me?
Brother Cosmos, looking like what again? Looking like what?
Okay. Begin to apply your distance.
Cosmos, what are all these things for now? No, Cosmos, you know I do not apply all these worldly things.
Worldly things? Those are worldly things. How would you attract a man to come and marry you out of this house looking so plain like this? Or aren't you tired of your friends and all the beautiful girls in this village getting married and leaving you in this village? Eh?
But Cosmos, I said I would not rob. I don't want to rub.
You won't rub? Rosa, start with the lipstick. Rub it now. Rosa, rub lipstick one. Rosa, rub lipstick two.
Brother Cosmos, I said I would not rub. I'm already attracted to Jesus Christ as I am, and he likes me this way.
Don't worry. Jesus will like you this way too.
I will not have a second one.
Which one is your color? Which one is your color? I can't set yourself here. Which one is your color?
So I will not rob this.
Come on! English. Go set yourself.
Because I will not rob. Leave me. No. I will not rob. Leave me.
You are not tired. You are not tired.
I will not have a second one. I will not have another one.
First, hold on. You're not tired. You're not tired of answering your father's name.
I said I will not help.
This is the way a beautiful girl should look. Don't you see the difference now? Now listen to me. As you go out now, if any man, any responsible man approaches you, just be cheerful and smile back at him. Do you understand me? Just smile back. Oh, this house must play host to palm wine and bright price. Do you understand me?
Yes. Now go.
Don't wipe that lipstick. Oh. Don't even touch your face.
I'm watching you.
Come on, stop me.
inside the room to one place and clean all this mess.
You must get married. Keep smiling, you know? You see, if your local government chairman has two wives, he's a thief. You know why?
Because must tell us.
It's simple logic, man. It's logic. You can only take care of one woman and her children's needs on one monthly income. But you cannot take care of two women and their children's needs on the same monthly income. So, if your local government chairman has two wives, check his pocket. You will see bribe money inside. You will see corruption money inside. You will see kickback money inside. Failed contract money too is inside.
So, what about the people that have two wives already before they became local government chairman?
Ah! You see those ones? They are thieves already. In fact, they shouldn't even be allowed to contest any election in this country at all, at all. In fact, you see, they were thieves before they were born.
Ha! Cosmos! So, what you're trying to tell me now is that any man that has more than two wives is a thief too?
Now. I mean, it's logic. It's simple logic. You should check things for yourself too. You see, the Bible even says that if you have two wives, you have collected another man's wife. Therefore, you should return that wife to the owner. Because God created one woman for one man. Alright? You have another man's wife.
But there are people that have like three wives, seven wives, even up to ten. And above even.
See those ones, stone them. Stone them!
God.
I'm telling you. See those ones, they are worse than armed robbers. I'm telling you, stone them. Charlie Passat, this one is okay, you can pay.
Okay.
Nkiru! Nkiru!
How much is your money?
He drank three bottles of. He drank three bottles, which is 300 naira.
Okay, 300 naira.
Okay. My the Charlie P.
Cost. Oh, yeah.
Charlie
give me
Passat.
My change, oh.
Well, thank you for buying me a drink,
What did you just say?
You got three bottles, a drink.
Okay, now, thank you for buying me three bottles of drinks.
Now you are talking. Don't worry. I'll go and smoothen the job for you between you and Rosa. Then later, we'll be talking about bride price. You know? Later, we'll talk about drinks. Later, we'll talk about marriage. Later, kids will arrive. You know, children will arrive. Then later, they will grow up, have plenty money to take care of their cosmos. No problem.
I trust you. Thank you.
The Charlie P.
Cosmos. Okay, now my in-law. Let's go.
My in-law.
Our in-law.
Stop that kind of play. What's that now? This is my in-law. Are you related to me? Is it your business?
No,
okay.
No problem.
Your
own.
Thank you. That's my the Charlie P.
Let's go.
Let's go.
The Charlie P.
Cost.
Correct guy.
The Charlie P.
Them. I trust you.
My sister.
I know.
I talk. Anytime she can't say nonsense. She can't say anything.
Yes, Nelly, my babe, my babe.
Your babe,
stop, 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 nah.
Stop. God bless you, my dear. God bless the road that you walk on. You know, that road that leads to your dear Cosmos.
Cosmos. Just today, I was thinking about you.
Are you serious?
True, and then I just met you on the way. How are you?
I'm fine, I'm fine, I'm fine. He who findeth a wife findeth a good thing. And also, he who findeth a woman that wants to marry him findeth great expectations.
Says Cosmos.
Says Cosmos. Says Cosmos.
Let's go now.
Ah, stop worrying me now. Ah, stop worrying me. Ah, what is it? Kiss me first.
No, 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 no. Kiss me. No, don't kiss. Your friend will hear the sound of the kiss.
You said
see, no, tomorrow I'll be alone in the house. Come to the house and I'll kiss you.
You said tomorrow.
Tomorrow, tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Calipasa!
Let's go.
Calipasa! see, no problem. I will now go in and smoothen the job, eh?
Yes.
Then I'll send her to come and see you. There's no problem.
No problem.
I hope you have money, you know, to arrange something for her. You know, these small, small girls now, they like, you know, ice cream, chewing gum.
Leave money for chewing gum and cream. You know, money can never be a problem between Rosa and myself.
Charlie P!
Just talk to her first!
Charlie P!
Charlie Passa!
No problem, no
okay,
problem.
I'm waiting for you here. Charlie Passa!
Rosa? 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 Rosa! 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 Rosa!
Okay. Ha! Rosa! Don't you know it's bad market for a woman to be caught in the toilet when her intended husband is around? It can reduce your value and your bride price too.
Rosa! Rosa!
Rosanna! Rosanna! Rosanna!
Wait, I'm coming, eh?
Don't panic!
Eh?
Don't panic! Don't panic! Just wait, don't panic.
As she waits.
Just wait, don't panic. Don't go.
Yeah.
Don't go.
Thank you.
If anyone leaves his father, mother, sisters, brothers, and other families to seek the kingdom of God, there's a great reward. A great reward that is more when beautiful girls like us, decides without being forced to become nuns and sisters, all for the kingdom of God. Rejecting husbands, children, and the joy of having sex and families of our own. About 4 years ago, when I decided to become a sister, I prayed to God that I don't want to be the only sister from my village, that you should touch the hearts of young girls like you to take the decision which I have taken. And today I'm happy because the four of you have taken this decision. I'm patiently studying for exams into the convent school. Praise be to Jesus. Yes, it's a good thing to get married and have children of your own. It's also a good thing to have sex. Like they said, it's sweet. I don't know how true. But think of how God will reward with peace and joy for denying yourself this pleasure. Or for the kingdom of God. However, if at any time before you enter the convent or while at the convent, if you're having any doubts about the vocation, please don't hesitate to drop out. It is better not to make God a promise than to make him a promise and fail. Praise be to Jesus.
Rosanna!
Rosa! Rosanna! Rosanna! Oh, so you're there, eh?
You're here again. You're here listening to somebody who is too ugly to attract a husband for herself. Eh, Rosanna? Eh? Someone who went to a native doctor and asked him to use the Aguba knife to slice off what makes her a woman. Eh? And she's here deceiving all of you, wearing white, because she has nothing to offer any man at night. Eh, you, Rosanna? Okay, you!
Why can't you just leave this innocent girl alone to serve God the way she has chosen for herself?
You are talking rubbish. Do you hear me? You are talking nonsense. Veronica, you are talking rubbish. Eh? Now tell me, how was Rosa born? Are you even going too far? How were you born? Isn't it because a man married a woman, slept with her, and did something to her? Eh? I mean, why are you discouraging all these beautiful girls from getting married? When in your 23 years of spinsterhood in this village, no man, not even a madman, came to your father's house to knock, to even rent you for one night, don't talk of marrying you.
It's enough, Cosmos. Sister Vera has not insulted you. Keep your farm out to yourself until the rest of your lives that God has punished you with the loss for earthly pleasures.
Me?
Please, Adana, please ignore him.
No! Let me talk to him. Is it every time we keep taking his nonsense simply because Rosa has refused to accept any of his arranged suitors?
You. We know you in this village now. You want to be a nun. Okay. We'll see how long you will last being a nun before this your body starts to scratch you. Not you.
Look at who is talking. You that your body has been scratching for 5 years now. Have you seen a penance to marry a wife? No. And yet you stand there asking me why I said God has punished you. He has punished you indeed. How can a 30-something-year-old he-goat like you find a wife and yet cannot find money to marry her? Don't you see that God has punished you? Punished you beyond repair.
Don't worry. You hear? Don't worry. Just stay here in this village, eh? Stay here in this village and see wonders, alright? Open your eyes. Open your eyes and see wonders. You will see Emilia's bride price paid. Alright? And she'll be my wife.
Why is this one laughing? No, why are you laughing? Has the vulture also learned how to sing where other beautiful birds sing?
We shall know who the vulture is very soon. When Mazo Jego, the local government chairman, pays the Emilia's bride price and buys a car each for her father and her relatives and marries her as a second wife.
Never! It can never happen. Emilia can never, ever, 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 ever be somebody's second wife. Do you understand me?
Rosanna! Come here! Come here!
Cosmos, go home. Go home. Rosa will return. She's only afraid that you will beat her up. That is why she's taking refuge here.
Naiwana. Is it fair? Is what Rosa doing fair? Wanting to become a reverend sister instead of getting married, is it fair?
Go home. The more she knows that you are here, the more threatened she will be. I will talk to her. You can as well talk to her later at night. I know she will see reasons with you.
It's all right. It's okay. I'll be going. Okay. Eh? But tell her to come.
You have no problem. Uh-huh. Rosanna.
Brother.
Rosanna.
Brother.
Rosanna. How many times did I call you?
Three times.
Rosanna, keep me alive. Rosanna, keep your brother alive. Is it too much for a brother to ask for? Is it too much for a brother to ask his sister for?
Brother, all my heart is in becoming a reverend sister. I do not want to marry anybody. I don't want to marry anybody.
Child! You see, that sister Veronica will never succeed with my own sister. Now let me refresh your memory a bit. You were barely 13 years old when Papa died, leaving us with nothing. He was heavily in debt, leaving only this house for us. Thank God he didn't sell off this house. If not, you and I wouldn't have a roof over our heads today. I dropped out of secondary school, started trading, and put you, Rosa, through secondary school. My business did not do well. Why? It was because the capital I invested was very small. Now tell me, how can a business do well when the only capital invested is just 2,300 naira? Anyway, I thank God you have grown up to become a very beautiful lady, wanted by a lot of men in Umuaro and other neighboring villages. Rosanna, Rosanna, I am a man. Rosa, I want to marry. Rosa, I want to build my own house so that I can park out of my father's house. Rosanna, I want to buy a car. I want to do so many things. And my only hope of doing these things is through the bride price that will be paid on your head. Rosanna, my life and my survival are in your hands. If you like, you keep me alive. If you like, let me die.
Bamba won and the Bajana Tachana. Bamba won and the Bajana Tachana. Oh, cause.
Welcome. Yes, sir. Okurama. Yes, sir. You meet me well. Please, sir.
Join me in drinking.
No. Next time.
You are a cunning boy. That was exactly what you did the other day. You came here and met me eating.
Nah, no problem. Next time I'll ask for more.
Are you sure?
Is my wife around?
Check her in the sitting room. She's reading for her forthcoming work exams.
Good girl. I'll go and check her inside.
But come, excuse me, cause
you called my daughter your wife, yes, and you have not paid any cob on her head, except by the word of mouth you used to tell me you will marry her 5 years ago when Emilia was entering to secondary school. Is it fair?
Nai, please, no problem. I'll still come and pay her bride price very soon. Trust me.
Our people say, Midiatana, Mazanguna, let the river never dry and let the fish never die. So don't disgrace me before my people.
I won't, Nai.
Okay. Right, you can go and see her.
Thank you, Nai.
Hey!
Hey,
Chiku, I'm looking at you. There's nothing to worry about.
There's nothing to worry about.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I keep hearing from all quarters in this village
that Chief Ojiego, our local government chairman, is a regular visitor to this compound. And you're telling me there's nothing to worry about. So I ask you now, Emilia, what does he come to this compound to do?
He came to discuss politics with Papa.
Politics?
Mm-hmm.
So he leaves all his political godfathers, who are his fellow thieves in the local government, to come and discuss politics with your father, who did not pass standard 4, and who doesn't know how to read and write.
Hmm.
Does your father look like a politician in his eyes?
I don't know.
Yeah. You started lying to me.
Are you trying to tell me now that Chief Ojiego hasn't asked your hand in marriage as a second wife? I mean, how can you deny something that is news all over every popular palm wine joint in Umuahra?
Did you hear that I've agreed to be anybody's second wife?
Okay, I ask you this now. Supposing Chief Ojiego chases his wife away.
Or still, if he did not have a wife, would you marry him?
Cosmos, don't query me like that though. Is he not a man? How am I supposed to know if I will not agree or not? Am I God?
You don't love me again. You seem to forget it's you and your father who ate the little money I made from trading.
Cosmos, don't talk like that. Because even now you know how much I want to be your wife. You said I should wait for 5 years and I've been waiting till now. So you want all the suitors to go away and then I reach my peak period before you now come and pay for my hand, Nabi? Then you'll be calling me your wife by word of mouth.
So what are you saying now?
I don't know. I'm saying that I want to marry you and I'll wait for you until after my work. After my work like this, anybody that comes to ask my hand in marriage, I will not refuse the person if I like the person. I've tried.
So what you're giving me right now is deadline, not so. It's alright. I have heard your deadline and I will meet it. I'll meet it. But first, kiss me now.
Papa will hear the sound of the kiss. Stop.
Rosanna! Stand up from there, idiot! Now listen to me. Emilia, my wife, has given me until the end of her SSC to pay her bride price. Now, I am not going to steal to pay that bride price. Neither am I going to do 419 to pay for that bride price. The money will come from your own bride price. Do you understand me? Now, I am giving you 2 months. Only 2 months to get married, or else. If I lose my Emily, if I lose my Emilia, to God, I'll bury you alive. I'll bury you alive.
But that Cosmos, I mean, Emily should not give you such a deadline. Unless, of course, she's no longer interested in the relationship.
Meaning what? No, go ahead, complete that sentence.
Meaning that maybe she... No, Maybe she does not love you anymore.
No, go ahead, complete it. No, repeat it again. Since you have stopped chewing gum and you now chew soap. Okuna Tancha, Rosa. Tomorrow, I will pay Charlie Passat a visit, alright? And I'm going to tell him to come with his people for introduction. Now, if you like, you run away. If you like, you stay in this house. But I promise you this one thing. I will make this house hell
on earth for you unless you get married and provide me with that thing I need to make me a full man again. Do you understand me? Do you understand me? Come on, come on, get that from here.
Afraid of what I will do to her
if she refuses to marry you.
Yes.
She'll be there to accept you and say yes. All you just need to do now is just bring your people with the bride price and pay tomorrow. Simple.
Tomorrow?
Yes.
How? That's a bit too hasty and sudden for me.
You want to marry my sister, not so?
Yes, but...
But what? Look, you better come tomorrow before I change my mind and collect money from Erasmus. If you don't know, Erasmus loves my sister more than we Christians love Jesus Christ too.
Cosmas, let me consult my father and the elders of my family on the matter. Then we'll fix the date and I will let you know.
So you will not come tomorrow as I've told you now?
You know now. You know that tomorrow is too sudden for me. You know.
Hey. Anyone listening to you now will think I'm begging you to come and marry my sister. Okay, if you say there's no rush, no problem. Charlie Passat, I will need small money. You know, I need you to give me small money, like 5,000 naira. You can deduct it when you come to pay for my sister's bride price.
God forbid! I will not do such a thing. Hi, to pay you upfront for my wife. Cosmas! Listen, let me tell you something. If you have no respect for your sister Rosa, I do. Do you understand?
Oh. So, it has now come to a matter of God forbid. Charlie Passat. It's now God forbid. So, this is the way you treat me when I eventually marry my sister off to you. Enkwa? Charlie, you are a stingy man. You are stingy. Ever since I've known you, the only thing I can boast of is a few bottles of palm wine and fried dog meat from Nwaiyaro's bar. I'm begging you for small money, 5,000 naira, and you're refusing. Is this the way you people marry your own compound? Ha! Okay,
I'll go and find my sister a generous man to marry. Because the way I see you, my sister will die of hunger if she should marry you in your own household. Because you're too stingy. Your hands are too tight. Today you even try itself. Look at it's malt I'm drinking instead of beer. You're too stingy.
Good evening, Chief.
Good evening, Ide. Why are you not at the gate?
There's a man here to see you, sir. He's at the gate.
He has no name, I suppose.
His name is... Cosmas. Yes, his name is Cosmas, sir.
What does he want?
He didn't say, sir.
Get the message from him. You see, I'm busy.
Sir, he refused to leave any message. He just said I should mention to you that it is a serious matter. Concerning a girl named Emilia. Yes.
I see. Send me.
Yes, sir. Here's the master.
Sit down. What is it you want to tell me about Emilia?
Chairman of Ofumba local government area. Sir, I want to correct something you just said now.
You called me a young man. I am not a young man. I am a full man, very much in need of a wife. Thank you.
That's funny anyway. Back to serious business. What is it you want to tell me about Emilia?
Well, since you have refused to ask me my name is Cosmos.
Okay, and?
You mean you don't know me?
No, what are you driving at?
Are you trying to say Emilia hasn't mentioned my name to you before?
She hasn't. Should she have?
Anyway, like I said, my name is Cosmos. And I'm the one who is supposed to marry Emilia. I don't have a farthing to pay her bride price yet. But you see, chairman of Ofumba local government area, sir, the love I have for Emilia is called killing love, which means I can kill anybody just to be with Emilia. So, as a peace-loving indigene of this community, I have come to you with this deal. I have a sister by name Rosa. She is 20 times much more beautiful than Emilia, and in my own eyes, much younger. Come and marry her. Come and love her. Pay her bride price so that I can use money from that bride price to pay Emilia's bride price. That way, I am happy. You're happy. Everybody is happy. Everything ends happily. Thank you. So, Chief, what do you have to say?
Yes. Can I speak with Philip? Yes, DPO. My life is in danger. There is a madman in my sitting room. Please phone your men on patrol. Let them come right away. Yes, please come right away.
Wait, excuse me, Chief. Were you just referring to me now?
Chief, come back now! Chief, I'm not mad. I'm only in love.
Well, it is Rosa I blame, and that Veronica who is misleading her from marrying.
It's all right.
Man, you have taken us by surprise.
Who is Cosmos?
Cosmos? What has he done this time?
Came to my house and introduced himself as Emilia's husband. Is it true?
Ah, Chairman, this is not a matter for outside the discussion. At least come into the house. I know you are angry. Let's go into the house.
Is he Emilia's husband?
Don't raise your voice on me. Have you lost respect for age my ones like myself? I say come into the house first.
Answer my question. I demand to know. Because I paid the million school fees this year. And bought all her books. Including the WAEC registration form.
In that case, ask Emilia herself. She's old enough to speak for herself. You cannot harass an old man like me because you are the chairman of local government area. Before your election, I've seen so many local government chairmen come and go.
Is Emilia in the house?
No.
How can I see her?
Go to Cosmos' house. She's there with him.
Cosmos?
Yes.
No. She should
She should not. Cosmas! Cosmas! Hi!
Let them
be. Cosmos, you don't have to go and explain how to show me that you love me. I know.
Right?
It's just that I'm under pressure. And my auntie says that
the moment I pass my peak period, I won't be able to give birth. No. She said that giving birth will be a problem because I've passed my peak period. See now? That's what I'm saying.
And then, you know, marry me for free now. Then I'll pay later.
No! God forbid! Cosmos, did your mother marry your father for free or on credit?
That's an insult.
Okay, I'm sorry you feel that way. But you to don't insult me by telling me to come and marry you for free or on credit though. You're insulting me now as a maiden of this land.
It's alright, I'm sorry.
Cosmos, you're just like a child. You know? You have the heart of a child. See the way you just said I'm sorry? So simply. You know, most men will not want to say they are sorry. They'll be feeling too proud to say they are sorry, even when they know that they are wrong. But you are different. That's what I like about you. Cosmos, I know that you've never hurt my feelings.
And I will never, never, never toy with your feelings.
I wish you were rich. Very, very rich.
That's another insult.
How?
Look, listen. I know I am a poor person, I'm a poor man, but you don't have to, you know, let it out of your mouth now.
Cosmos, are you afraid of the truth?
Emilia, you better apologize for that thing that just came out from your mouth now.
No, I haven't said anything wrong.
You just said I am poor.
But you are a poor man. That's the truth.
I'm poor.
Yes, now.
Emilia, I'm poor.
Okay, come and see me. Stop acting childish. Oh yeah, I'll go if you don't want to escort me home again. I'll go. I'm going. Okay, now I'm going now.
The Bible tells us that our body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. And if our body is the temple of the Holy Spirit, aren't we not to keep our body free from all uncleanliness and sins of the flesh?
Yes.
Rosa, brother is coming. So
if any of you wants to get injured today, let the person come here. If any of you wants to spend her night in the village health care center, let that person come here now.
You come here.
So Veronica, you can fear. It's a very good thing. It's a very good thing that you can fear like this because I'm ready to kill. kill somebody today.
I don't see your fellow men all over the place to fight. It's a woman you're bringing out your
mouth. Hey, I want to fight a woman. Just sharpen your mouth here. If you sharpen down your mouth, I'll be telling you. I'll just kill you here now.
Shame on you.
Shame on who? Shame on who? Idiot. Come, come. You.
You have not disobeyed your elder brother.
Come, come, move.
Go to academia.
Go. You even find yourself, you should have been ugly. Pay me better. Now, come here, come, come. Now, give me one reason why I shouldn't hate you. Look, give me another reason why I shouldn't come at this face with slaps. Eh?
What do you talk like? I do not have a mind of my own. But of course, was I have a mind of my own, and you have to realize I'm a full grown woman now. And I can take decisions for myself. And I insist that I will not get married.
So, I suffered everything I suffered to make you a human being today, and you're here opening this your mouth, telling me you're a grown woman that can do anything she wants to do. Ewa, Toto, say that once and if I come out of this, your face with slaps.
Rubbish.
Toto, tell me you're a beautiful grown woman now.
Now listen to me. Listen to me. Come here. Come here. Come here.
Listen to me. Listen to me. I forbid you from going to see that Veronica again. Do you understand me? If not, I will lock you up in this house. I'm slapping up. I'll lock you up in this house until this your madness erases. Come, 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 make food for me. Get out of here, dude. I go to work on there. All other people have fine sisters and they are looking at them as Naira sign. My own is Bible sign.
Gotten to the extent of you sneaking out of this house without greeting me.
Good morning, brother. I wanted to greet you, but you were having your bad that time.
Where are you going with that Bible? Answer me, where are you going?
I'm going to Sister Vera's house. Her vacation is almost ending, so she said that all of us should come to our house this morning.
Everything I told you yesterday, you didn't take it serious. Let me show you how serious I can be now. Come! Come on! You tell me if it's Vero that feeds you in this house.
Brother Cosmos, please now. Please.
In our wine, believe it.
Listen,
there's yam in the house, do you understand? If you're hungry, You cook and eat, alright?
What if I want to go to toilet?
Come on, come on. Do it there.
Hey, would I please now, please, don't be like this now. Be quiet me now, please.
Cosmas, my son.
I have heard all your complaints concerning Sister Veronica.
Right now, she has gone to church.
I promise you, when she returns back,
I will ask her if she is the one forcing Rosanna not to get married, but to become a sister like her.
Well, I have only respected you as Vero's uncle, and come to report her first to you before I spoil her name in this village. I mean, since Veronica came to this village on holidays, all the beautiful girls that would have made good wives for her men have started embracing her madness. Yes! Madness of not getting married.
Like I said, Cosmas, I will ask her if she's the one forcing them, or if they volunteer to serve God out of their own will.
Mm. Yes. As housemaids. Eh? Listen, God does not need any housemaid or house help in heaven. He is God and he can do all things perfectly by himself. Look, just call that your Veronica to order. Call your list to order before I show her in this village.
I will not support her if she is forcing them. Or, but if the girls wanted to be like a Sister Veronica, there's nothing I can do about it.
That's what you're saying.
Yeah.
Well, in that case, I will have no choice but to report her to her people. That's it.
No problem, Cosmas. Her people in Christ are not fools. They can tell the chaff from the seeds. Yes. Yes.
So like chaff from seeds.
Yes.
We will know who is chaff and who is seed in this village.
Yeah.
Father, good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm not fine. I thought you had already driven off.
Well, after the morning mass, I stayed a little behind because Sister Veronica and I had a little to talk about. So what's the problem?
Veronica is my problem.
Sister Veronica?
Sister Vero. She's spoiling my sister for me.
How?
My sister already has a husband and now she wants to disappoint her husband because Veronica has taught her that marriage kills young girls.
Let me ask you, has your sister in any way or manner indicated that she's being forced to become a reverend sister?
She doesn't need to indicate. The picture is very glaring, it's very clear. Veronica is spoiling my sister.
Anyway, you don't have to worry yourself. I will speak duly to Sister Vero about the matter.
Speak with her. Speak with her. I know she will listen to you. Speak with her. Speak with her, because she's spoiling my sister for me.
Now you can go, eh?
Okay.
May the good Lord bless you.
God, please bless me. Bless me. Because I've not stolen anybody's yam. In fact, I've not stolen your own yam. I've not stolen your goat. And I'm still suffering on earth here. Bless me. Father, one how. One how.
Coming here to beg me will not change anything. I've told you several times, I cannot be a second wife. No matter the amount of money or anything you give me, I can't be second wife now. I cannot.
So what do you want me to do now, seeing that I love you too much to have no finance?
I don't know. You figure it out yourself.
If I send my first wife away, will you marry me if I do?
Maybe. Maybe if you send your first wife away, am I married?
But how will I do that? We are happy. I'm highly worried. Everything is fine with both of us.
So why do you want another wife?
The way I feel about you, and the way you make me feel. My hair swims in the clouds whenever I see you.
Maybe if you go home and you start picking quarrels with her, then it will lead to problems that will lead to divorce. Then you can send her away. That's if you want to. Emili, not force you. Stop looking at me like that.
Emili, do you want me to kneel down for you?
That's lustfulness, so. Stop now.
Emili, you know I love you, bro.
It's not funny!
Darling, you're welcome. You're home so early today. How was your day?
I'm hungry. I need my food. Is my food ready?
Not quite. We weren't expecting you home so early, so by the time you change your clothes, wait a little, your food will be ready.
Meaning what, Florence? What do you mean you are not expecting me this early? So you were expecting me to die at the office? Hmm? Yeah. Give me my food now or there'll be trouble in this house.
Chief, I don't understand you this afternoon. You normally come back between 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. Even later than that. Today you're back by 2 p.m. You're quarreling and getting upset over food.
You have said it. You have let it out that you are happy whenever I'm not in this house. You are happy whenever I come back late and spend little time in my own house. I got news for you. Your plans have failed. Instead of me to leave my house or not to come back to my house on time, you are the one to leave my house.
Where have I gone wrong, Chief? My head. Chief, come back. Then what did I do to you, Chief?
Emilia!
Oh, Emilia.
Emilia, why? Emilia, look at my leg.
Emilia, come back to the car.
Emilia, just look at my leg, Emilia. Just see how her block has scattered my leg, Emilia. When I went to look for money for our marriage, Emilia, now you followed another man, Emilia. Why?
Come back here now. Come and enter the car. We don't have time for that rubbish.
Come on. Come on.